G'day, welcome to the Great South East. Well, I don't really need to tell you where we're standing this afternoon or point out the beautiful setting that lays there behind us. We've used this vantage point many times over the years, but for me today, it's with a different perspective. I'm sad to say that this will be my final episode in the Great South East. We're packing the family up. Don't get too sad there, guys. We're packing the family up and heading to the big bright lights of Sydney, and so I suppose this is a special episode for me. I believe we're going for a stroll through the gardens of Mount Cutha to celebrate this fact.
Rupert, you've actually been led astray, I'm sorry. We're here to help celebrate your contribution to the show by choosing some of our favourite Rupert stories over the last 4.5 years. I'm sorry. You'll love it. You'll absolutely love it.
I'm sure I will.
Here's what we have in store. Aniela's looking at sporty Rupert, particularly the ones you were less than successful at. Sally's chosen a heart racer when you measured up as a bull rider. Martin's talking country. Remember that property you visited called Wattle Downs? And we'll let you choose a favourite of your own. But first, I've always liked the stories where we had a bit of fun together, like when we girls took on you boys at putt-putt.
OK, guys, listen up. As host of the show, these are the rules. I want to see a fair game out there today. No cheating. No back chat, especially from you guys. Okay, we're going to play the Jurassic side. You go and play the Egyptian course, and at the end of 18 holes, whoever's got the lowest score, champions of the Great Southeast.
That's
as long as it's us.
It's us.
Walk like an Egyptian.
I've got putt-putt running through my veins. I'll kick us off.
Get in.
Yes, go.
Come back.
On the back.
OK, Sal, they're up against the wall.
What's the little funny?
I don't know. I'm guessing.
A little bit further, but...
No cheating, Rupert. Ready?
Oh, yeah. Very nice work.
Hang on, it's coming back.
That's it in two. Well done.
So, things may have started out a bit shaky, but after warming up on that first hole, Bowman and McCall's confidence soared. But we started feeling a little less confident after we saw the girls in action.
For the game. Oh, beautiful. Two. We can play.
Here we go. What did you guys score?
No. Let's see yours first.
56.
Why?
We're 35.
Well,
yeah, we're beating.
If it wasn't for that 27 on the 15th, Martin,
and if it wasn't for Sally was OD'd on coffee.
Yeah. Too much coffee for Sally.
Next up on the show, Rupert has a go at wakeboarding. I remember it well.
To the Great Southeast. Well, the thing we love about our Rupert is that he's always willing to have a go at anything. He's a pretty fit-looking bloke and he does regard himself as a rugby and touch footy player, but we here on the Great Southeast like to get him out of his comfort zone and doing things a little bit different. And Rupert, I must say, I had to laugh that time I saw you water skiing and wakeboarding at Lake Somerset.
Thank you, Aniela. Yes, it was very funny. I think one of the original qualities of my job description, apart from being good-looking and well-mannered, was the fact that they were after someone stupid enough to do anything that was thrown in front of him, and of course, I qualified perfectly. The Spit at Lake Somerset is an ideal day trip destination and a regular meeting place for members of the Queensland Ski Racing Association. Now, these guys can ski, reaching speeds of up to 150 kilometres per hour. But for today, forget the speed. Their mission was to try and teach me the very basics of water skiing.
Not really.
That's the beginner's stance. They all end up like that. You will end up like that.
Well, I...
Okay.
Can we cut that out?
No. Righto, the skis are on. I've got my riding instructions. I think it's time to hit the water. I don't think we quite reached speeds of 100 miles per hour. That wasn't quite as elegant either. But that's pretty good fun. I think I'm ready for the wakeboarders. Bring on the chicken salad. The chicken salad is one of the many original names given to wakeboard manoeuvres. It's Australia's fastest growing water sport and similar in style to snowboarding. Got the roast beef, the chicken salad.
The air railie and the crocked oil.
And what's your favourite?
The crocked oil would have to be my favourite.
Do you reckon I can handle it, mate?
Yeah, no worries, mate.
Sure. Okay, so it took a few goes, but finally I got it. They may not have the speed of a water skier, but they sure make up for it with style.
Rupert, such style and finesse.
Not.
I know we've spoken before about some of the more challenging moments you've had on the show, and let's face it, he has been sent on some hairy assignments, but the one you picked as up near the top of the list was bull riding.
Exactly. I think of all the things that I've done in the Great Southeast, this was the most frightening. I mean, when you're jumping out of a plane or doing crazy things on water skis, you only rely on yourself, but when you're sitting on top of the biggest, meanest bull in South East Queensland, you don't know what he's going to do, and I must admit, it was very, very scary.
Mention the word Kingaroy, and straight away people think of it as a peanut-growing area. More recently, a wine-growing region. But up until now, I wasn't aware that Kingaroy is also renowned for its radio adventures. And courtesy of this radio school, just on the outskirts of town, I'm about to learn a few lessons. Hopefully not the hard way.
Just out of town is a small township called Goodja. And that's where you'll find Tim Kelly and his group of extra keen students. Tim has been riding in radio since he was about 14 years old and estimates he's ridden over 1,500 bulls during his career.
When the hooter goes, or it's time, you have to, you're looking here, all you do is you take your focus from here, pull your hand out and just land on your hands and knees and then get going. Get running quickly. And if you're knocked out, still get up and run.
Okay, I've listened to the safety lecture. Got the safety gear on, the spurs, the Aussie flag chaps, more importantly, the safety vest, and a little bit later on, the helmet. They tell me that 8 seconds of bull riding is the equivalent of 80 minutes of football, so you've also got to do your stretches. Most important, the back and the groin. After the stretching, it's time for a demonstration of the real thing.
The thing we've got to think about is we want to not stir the animal up at all. We want to go as quietly as we can, because we don't want him upset in here. We want to be able to get on him quietly and get out. Right now. Right up now. The fun is in the arena, not in the chutes. Right up. OK. Get up. And that's where you win the money.
Right, you've got to get right up on your rope, as far as you can, yeah, like that. And, now, don't put your feet back. Your feet have got to go forward, down underneath here, near the bills.
I jumped off a perfectly good cliff once, parasailing. This could be the craziest thing that I've ever done. Adrenaline is out of control. Don't worry, my legs are shaking. OK, mate.
OK, keep your free hand.
Lead over him.
Believe it or not, I lasted the 8 seconds, and I tell you, after you get over the initial fear, to actually have a go, ride the bull, and come back in one piece, it was all worth it.
The Great Southeast team remembers our own much-loved Jason Rupert McCall. Rupert was born November the 26th, 1970, to Prawny and Kerry McCall, a son of the Redcliffe Peninsula. He was a good student, but sports crazy, so much so that after completing a university degree and just 1 year into his term with a law firm, he packed it in to make a career out of writing poetry about his favourite sports stars. In 1996, Rupert made his first appearance on television, in fact on Channel 7, reading and acting out one of his poems about football called The Winter Whiting Blues.
I beckoned Dale to be a pal and hit me with a pilly, then like a truck. The answer struck. I roar the name of Gilly!
On October the 8th, 1997, hot on the heels of being named the Sunday Mail's Bachelor of the Year, he began his role as host of the Great Southeast. Since then, that bachelor has met and married his lovely wife, Kate, and become the adoring father of two beautiful children, Ella and Jacob, all of whom have made appearances on our show. Rupert leaves us to pursue a career in Sydney. He already has a regular weekend appearance on the Seven Network show Sports Watch. Rupert, we wish you well.
Rupert, you've really covered some territory in your time, haven't you? I mean, Charleville, Childers, everywhere in between.
Yeah, it's been one of the great things. I think one of the success stories of the show has been showing you, the viewers, what is in our own backyard here in South East Queensland.
Yep, and when I was asked to choose one show to show for this last time, I thought of that time you flew out to a property. Was it Wattle Downs?
Yes, it was.
Yeah, great story.
Yeah, I've got a bit of a rural vein in my blood, I must admit, marrying an Augathella girl. And the time we went to Wattle Downs, well, it was certainly memorable.
Said there'd be a limo waiting at the airport for me. I'll tell you what, this gives the phrase new meaning. Are you ready to go?
I've just arrived at Wattle Downs, a working stud merino sheep property covering over 2,300 hectares at the Gums in the heart of the Australian bush. The Gums is a small township about 2.5 hours west of Toowoomba and 4 hours drive from Brisbane. And Wattle Downs is 13 kilometres south of that. Golden Air Tours operate direct flights to Wattle Downs from Coolangatta Airport, which cuts the travel time back to about 1 hour.
And the fact that we've cut down our travel time means that we get here earlier, giving us more time to enjoy some of those traditional farm things. At the moment, the limo's taking us off for a dose of billy tea and damper, and I'm looking forward to it.
Our quick rest stop allowed me just enough time to slip into work mode, country style.
As is often the case, when you're spending some time out on the property, there's always something happening where you can lend a hand. You ought to go again? All right.
The afternoon's activities consisted of mustering the sheep up to the yards to separate the rams from the ewes and their lambs. Wattle Downs is owned by Bill Huskisson and his wife Loma. And as you can see, all farm visitors are welcome to get in on the act. Karen Steadman is Bill and Loma's daughter, and she's responsible for the farm stay side of things at Wattle Downs.
For a city slicker like myself, to come out to a place like Wattle Downs, what have you got to offer?
Oh, where do you want me to start? well, I suppose our main attraction is the fact that it's the real thing. This is how
it
is.
What you see is what you get.
Yep, and this is our life. So basically it's experiencing our lifestyle and what we do every day.
At the end of a good day's work, you've got your choice of a fully hosted farm stay. That's what I like.
Isn't it fun?
Or you can light the campfire and do it the fun way. What do you reckon about this, girls?
Great.
Just as good.
this is the slippery part. I've just copped a big splash of water in the face and it threw me for a minute, but we're back on track now. Well, this is where the adrenaline starts to pump and the ticker starts to work overtime. They call this the point of no return. So it's sit back and enjoy the ride.
Yee-hoo!
I'll see you at the bottom. Well, there's so many stories to choose from when it comes to my favourite episodes of the Great Southeast. Canyoning is certainly up there. It was a long way down that day. But as opposed to abseiling down the side of a cliff, my favourite story was the day that I jumped off the cliff, attached to a parachute, thankfully, paragliding with the wedge-tail eagle. I think it has to be my favourite. Let's have a look. Canungra is just south of Tambourine Mountain, about 60 minutes southwest of Brissy and 30 minutes inland from the Gold Coast. The Canungra area is one of the most popular spots in southeast Queensland to go paragliding. With all the thrills and excitement of hand gliding, only portable and launchable from anywhere, they tell me if I put one of these on my back and take that leap of faith, then I'll know what it feels like to fly like an eagle.
Ready to go flying?
I am ready. If you are.
Yeah. I'm always ready, mate. For something as fun as flying paragliders, I'm always ready.
Paragliders are launched from gentle sloping hillsides where the canopy is first laid out on the ground behind the pilot. The backpack becomes the specially designed reclining harness which attaches to the paraglider, and of course the pilot must wear a safety helmet.
There we go. Good, mate.
So, I feel like Tom Cruise out of Top Gun, mate, ready to fly.
Yeah, wait till you're in the air, you'll know the other thing. Now, when we start going, I'm gonna say 1, 2, 3, launching. As I say 3, launching, we're going to start moving forward.
Walk, jog, run.
Yep. Okay. By the time we get to here, we should be off well and truly flying.
Okay. Once the instruction is complete, all the paraglider pilot needs is wind no greater than 15 knots and a lot of patience before finally it's time to give it a go and take to the sky. I'm a bad boy,
breaking her heart. Yossi!
Unbelievable, mate. Doesn't get too much better than this in the Great Southeast. Unbelievable. That was sensational, mate. Absolutely sensational. Okay, get the roadrunner legs going.
Oh. I knew it would be on.
Thanks, mate. All right. That was worth waiting for.
Oh, for sure. And we just got it right, too. The wind just came on.
The wind picked up on cue, and we could have stayed up there all afternoon.
And just tell me about that wedgie up there.
And the wedgie. We were flying with the wedgie. Flying alongside a wedge-tail eagle, silently gliding over spectacular landscape, as Phil says. Paragliding's a sport that you can't sum up in words. You've just got to get out there and do it. You don't need any prior experience to go tandem paragliding, just a sense of adventure. Now, I've had an individual list of all the people that I would like to thank for making my time in the Great Southeast such an enjoyable experience. The list would be too long. So generally, thank everyone, including you guys, being part of the crew. All the people up there at Channel 7 who work so hard and do a tremendous job, and you guys, the viewers, who always make it such a great time out and about in the Great Southeast. Now, I won't be back next week to say that, but safe to say, thanks for your company, as always.
Before we go, Rup, I have done a little poem for you. You know I'm not good at poetry, and I'm doing it to the expert, but see how you go.
Hello.
Rupert, we're going to miss you, so we'll say goodbye and kiss you. But don't forget when you bet, you're maroon and not a blue.
Thanks, Laura. Take
care. Told you I wasn't.
And for Rupert McCall.
Get ready to laugh.
Help me.
I thoroughly recommend it.
Hey, this is supposed to be Vietnam, but I feel like a rat of Tobruk. Dressed to fly.
Queensland origin legend, Trevor Gilmeister. How are you, Gilly?
Good, mate.
This is definitely a step up. I'd like you to meet Tuffy.
Yes, there is.
Pretty soon we'll be connecting up with Beth Nebo Rose. Oh, that's it. That's it. It's the best thing I've done. The flying stops and the gliding begins.